What's going on, Charles Bodstedt? So I'm going to continue on this topic of fear, happiness, addiction. Why? Because it's really the feelings that we're either chasing or we're avoiding. Fear, we're obviously avoiding. Addiction, we're chasing. Addiction, you know, anything that it comes down to going after, which is comfort, security, you know, things like that. Today we're going to be talking about the if-then model. So in other words, if I do this, then I will be happy. And not happy as in long term, like if I get married, then I'll be happy. Not that big. I mean even small things, which is if I snooze my alarm, I'm going to be able to sleep longer. If I snooze my alarm and I don't get out of bed, then I'm going to have more comfort, safety, and security. If I don't approach that pretty girl or ask that guy out, then I'm actually going to be in this little bubble that I'm used to, okay? And I'll just talk about two people. Number one is Will Smith. So Will Smith and Travis Pastrana. So both of them have actually said in different ways that when they feel too comfortable, they actually, like in life, like if they're doing something and they get this like weird feeling. So in other words, they have an aversion. Most people have an aversion to fear. Most people have an aversion to something that they're trying to chase, but if they don't get it, chase a gold medal, the number one, or in Will Smith's, you know, so say an award or acting or whatever, is that they say, if I am comfortable, I feel weird. They actually have a weird feeling. They have an uncomfortable situation of being comfortable. So most people, it's the opposite. When they are comfortable, or when they're uncomfortable, they feel, they're like, I need to go back into comfort. When Travis Pastrana and Will Smith feels comfortable, they're like, I got to do something to get out of this. I have to get out of this equilibrium. I have to remove myself out of this situation because it's too easy. So they keep on pushing themselves. And anyone that we see that keeps on pushing themselves are ones that actually they feel the fear and they do it anyway. So in other words, if I feel fear, then I will. What do? Continue? Do you give up? Do you think about it more? Do you delay it? Do you procrastinate? If I feel I have a big project, what do? Do I go on my computer? Do I go on my cell phone? Do I look at YouTube videos? If it's mine, of course, you continue. However, the if-then model is something that if, this is the thing, and I'll just leave you guys at this, is that some people say, oh, I'm overweight or I'm not smart or something. It's like, okay, why? Why? Like, be curious. So the first thing is to actually say, okay, if I'm not getting good grades, why? Is it the teacher? Is it the subject? Or you can have full accountability, just like Jocko Willick said, I think that's his name, the Navy SEAL that said full or extreme ownership. In that book, he says, everything is your fault. Tom Bayou, or I forgot how to say his name, from The Impact Theory said, even if he's sleeping, and a meteor hits and he dies, and say he's at St. Peter and the Golden Gate or the door to get into heaven or whatever, he will say it was his fault because he chose to sleep in that room at that time. He didn't choose to go speaking while the meteor hit, or he didn't choose to go out. So in other words, he has extreme ownership. Everything is his fault. So when you have the if-then model, if I feel this way, or if this result happens, you have to reverse engineer and say, okay, I'm overweight, or I'm looking to get into a relationship. And right now, if I stay comfortable, or if I don't talk to pretty girls or ask that guy out, or if I don't make sales calls, then I'm gonna have no sales, okay? If I blah, blah, blah. So you have to reverse engineer, as Elon Musk says, the first principles theory. So the first principles theory essentially says that you remove all things that have essentially been fact up until that point. So I'll just give you the quick example before we leave you, is that Elon Musk was told that you can't make an all-electric car go for hundreds of miles at a time. And he said, why? And they said, well, the battery's too expensive. And he said, why is the battery too expensive? And they said, well, number one, it overheats. Number two is it really hasn't been made for a car that also doesn't have a combustible engine. And number three is there's no battery factory in the world that can actually support a mass production of batteries for cars. So he said, okay, well, let's build it. And they said, well, the technology's not there. He said, okay, well, let's improve the technology. So in other words, he's saying, people are saying, you can't actually do this because. So if you're looking to build a car, then you can't, or then it's too expensive, or then it can't be mass produced. So what is one area that you're saying a result needs to change? So you have to look at the result. The result is you're overweight, you're not eating healthy, or whatever the case is. Reverse engineer and say, okay, what causes that? And then you can either change the habit, you can instill a new habit, you can delete the habit, you can do something, but as long as you see the cause and don't see the cause as any external reason for you not to succeed, which is, you know, the market conditions aren't good enough, I don't have the money, or the you know, it's a recession. You know, one of the best companies that comes out of a recession, they always come out stronger, and one of the greatest companies are usually started in a recession because everyone else is wiped out and they see a need, all the money goes there. The iPhone went literally through the recession unscathed because it was a quality product. Money was still available, it just was not trading hands as easily. So the if-then model, see the result, see what you need to change, then is the result, if is what happens. Reverse engineer all of your fears, your addictions, the things you want to change, your habits. Have an awesome day. Subscribe to the video. Hope this helps a little bit. Leave your comments below. Talk to you guys soon.